film about the Orpheus Centre that was opened in 1998 by Sir Richard Stilgoe. It's a college for young disabled adults. Rory Dyer was the first funded student or apprentice of the new Orpheus Centre. And this is a film about a performance and rehearsal that was put on by Anne Lovelace, who's a long-standing volunteer of the centre.
Yeah.
Okay, we're on. So, Rory, I just... We're obviously making this movie about the history of Orpheus, and the reasons and how you got to be the first ever student. So you did tell me the other day, and it was you did tell it really well. So could you
Well, but basically, Orpheus started. It was initially Richard Stilgoe's house where he brought up his family.
Yeah.
And due to it being at the M25, they weren't able to sell it. And Richard at the time was doing some courses, art-based courses with disabled people, that were only 1 week a year. So the idea came that he created the Orpheus Centre from his old house, or using his old house as part of it, and then adapting it so that the courses and the life skills could continue on. That's how that started. And then how I became involved personally, I didn't know it was connected at the time. The older boys of my school, I was at the Trelaw school, and the boys at the upper school, as it was known at the time, were doing a play, and they needed somebody younger to play a younger part. It was a futuristic play called The Star and the Stone, and I played the assistant of the main character. And then a woman who was annotating it for the Barclay Awards, which we won, knew Richard Stilgoe. And Richard was looking to use a school at the time, this is back in 94, to promote the idea of Orpheus, and that was how I was first involved. That's the story.
Hmm. So, did you say Richard already was holding that kind of thing up in Orpheus, before it was Orpheus?
Yes, he was. It was a range of courses called Share Music, which was introduced to him as a concept of able and disabled people working together,
right,
by a guy called Michael Swallow. And so Orpheus initially was a furthering of that concept. The courses were started in 1985, and then in 1988 Richard held his first ever course at the house in the barn that still exists as part of Orpheus today.
The sort of the theatre part, isn't it? The barn theatre.
Yeah.
Okay, so you were the first student.
I was the first funded student. Yeah. I'd met people on courses who were to become students, and in some cases, enablers who were to become staff later, or regular people or tutors at Orpheus. So I'd met some of them prior, but I was the first funded student.
Right. So when you actually started, you were there, but there were others as well? Or?
Yes, there was the first five apprentices, as we were called in those days, were myself, Angus, who you know, and probably most people who are watching the show don't know Angus now. Angus, Danny, who was very skilled with lighting. There was Jamie, who was a very skilled musician. He spoke through a communicator. And Lorna, who's now a dance tutor, and we were the original five.
Excellent, yeah. Okay, so we're going to cut that off for a bit now.
Okay.
Okay, Rory, when you first started at Orpheus, what was the curriculum, and what were you actually learning there, and what was the sort of routine, daily routine there?
Well, we were doing a string of courses to start off with initially, because they were trying to get the program together. The courses being at the centre itself, at the Opera House, at Notting Hill Carnival, all kinds of places, and all kinds of tutors, dance, musical theatre, music tech, a whole range of stuff was going on.
Mm-hmm.
And And that was with us as people that live there, but also outsiders. Outsiders being the people that came in from the outside to work on each individual course.
Was that like day students? Or?
No, in those days you could board there as well as having day students.
Because it's quite a way out for day students, isn't it?
Well, today they have day students. Today they have day students that come there. We did, as I say, we did courses with people coming in from outside. And then when we as apprentices, as we were called then, as I said earlier, would do our day-to-day program, it would be life skills, it would be shopping, it would be our own projects within Orpheus itself, it would be working with people, again, from outside, but on individual sort of ad hoc rehearsals or whatever, and people would have their own individual programs within that, as well as being in a group together.
Yeah.
And then I branched out later into the thing in Lipa with Paul McCartney's college. And before leaving Orpheus, I went to Chicken Shed, which is another theatre company. And now I live back here where we're sitting now.
So you're living in this lovely flat, yes, in Fulham.
Yeah.
Has it really helped you, the life skills and stuff like that? Has it been like an invaluable sort of help? What they taught you?
Yes, indeed. Certainly in terms of money, budgeting, confidence, and those kind of things. Mm. But those weren't really executed until I was doing things in Liverpool, things really outside of the Orpheus context.
Yeah.
And that's what they're trying to do today, is to keep in contact with the students after they leave.
Mm.
When I was in Liverpool, I thought, I'm really doing this now, I'm really working. And even when I was working with you and we met here, that's the real functionality of what that was intended to do.
Yeah. And Orpheus really helped you with that. I mean, you're a pretty outgoing guy anyway. You're sort of sociable, and so you've already got a lot of the skills anyway.
Well, I probably had something that could be worked on when I went to Orpheus in terms of things that were there, whether they be social skills or acting skills or both or whatever it was.
Mm.
But they certainly needed the confidence and the enhancements and all those kinds of things that Orpheus added to it, really. And that's what you have to have when you start out, is that bit of confidence that's then worked on.
And you've how many CDs have you done? You've written songs and recorded them?
Well, we did quite a few projects with Orpheus, and I now work with ArtsEd. Work as a volunteer, I should say. Volunteer with ArtsEd. And that's a very recent thing, because that's come as part of Orpheus the Mythical, a consequence of Orpheus the Mythical, which we did earlier this year. Mm. And you and I saw the recording together, you might remember.
Sure.
The effect of Orpheus for me is still lasting on, really.
Mm.
But everybody who was there live in their own specific areas, so I've also got another life in London.
Yeah.
And probably get called back roughly around twice a year to do a given project, as you and I have recently done with Anne, and that's what's on the video as well, isn't it?
That's it, and we've got the rehearsals and the actual day of the performance, but if you need to see the performance, you'll have to get the DVD itself,
mm-hmm.
the Orpheus DVD, which is very good,
mm-hmm.
recommend it. Okay, that's the next bit. Okay.
30th of September 2018, Rory Dyer and Paul Howard on our way to the Orpheus rehearsal for the show, which is happening on the 6th of October. So today you'll see the inner workings of the performance, hopefully, and the journey to it, and the journey back, and anything else that happens along the way. Join us.
See you later.
So we're just filming a bit of train scenery.
The lovely Thames there behind you.
And let's hope we have as much drama in Orpheus as we did at the station this morning.
Because one of the lifts was broken. And I went on a rant at the station master, because he said, "It's health and safety, mate." And that's, to me, that's like a red rag to a bull. Okay, yes.
Well, there we are. If I knew what Paul was going to say, I could lip sync what he is saying, because of course we can't see him because he's behind the camera.
And the air turned blue as well. It's not. I don't think the language is appropriate for the family audience,
right?
Somehow.
There's Imperial Wharf. Right, go on, it's on.
So we should now see Anne coming to pick us up at the front door here.
Hopefully.
And that's all we can say, really.
Really, yes.
So it's a question.
And here she is.
Ah, here's Anne. And directly on the video.
Yes.
Oh, God.
Oh, God. Okay. So the camera was on, so I'll leave it on. Go on. So here we are.
Hello, Rora.
Lunchtime.
All the better to proceed.
Ready for action.
So now we're going to pay another homage to Roald Dahl with his version of Little Red Riding Hood. I think that's the best way to put it.
So, do we do?
You brave, it's us two.
Is it?
This is one of the big numbers here.
Because it was different.
Right. What we're doing is after Angus and Joe. Sometimes I think I glimpse eternity. Everyone sings. The whole of that chorus, and then you keep singing the tune, Luke. More than I can be. You raise me up. And it's the only time that chorus happens.
Do you want me to sing it?
And I really need you to be just singing through it. Okay, so let's do the full chorus. Okay, we've just had Angus singing. I think I've glimpsed eternity. Everybody now.
Bing.
You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas.
After the rehearsal, we're going to be publishing this video after the actual performance, and I hope you're enjoying it. And our next report will be from Starbucks, where we're heading next.
Starbucks or Cafe Nero?
Oh no, it's Cafe Nero. You can tell that I'm tired. I'm getting my words mixed up.
Lucky I'm around, eh?
Yeah, we had a good rehearsal. It's Cafe Nero. See you there. Well, here we are back at Nero, soaking up the atmosphere after a hard but worthwhile rehearsal. I hope we've put lots of extras and lots of detail into this film. And we can't depart without some input from our film man, Paul. Paul, reflections?
Well, I think it's been a great day. I'm having a coffee and a bit of carrot cake. And it's delicious. And it's been absolutely marvellous, as you can see from the singing and Rory's input as well. Very diverse. What's the word, anyway? Anyway, very versatile, that's the word I was looking for.
It's been a versatile movie.
It's been all right. It's been all right. We're tired, but anyway.
Yes.
So we're going to call it a day now, and great knowing you guys.
See you next.
Yeah.
See you next time.
Yeah. Yeah.
A week after our first instalment of footage for The Real Show, 6th of October 2018, Rory Dyer and Paul Howard. This is going to be a kind of docu-show of The Real Show, and as you can see, we're at my house and we're raring to go. We're just awaiting the cab, so join us on The Real Show Day.
And this is Fulham, West London, and the pressure's on. This is the big show.
Two big shows, to be exact.
Oh, okay.
But this is our kind of docu-show.
Yeah. Showtime!
You could say that, yes.
Okay, go on.
Here we are, outside the Orpheus, ready to go
ready
into
to go in. There's Anne again. Rehearsal is over, and there's the auditorium. What have you got to say, Rory?
Yes, in a few hours' time it'll be filled for two performances. We've made it down here, obviously, reasonably smoothly, and I'm pleased to say the rehearsal's gone equally smoothly.
They went very well. And the barn's looking wonderful.
Yes. And we're just about to go and have some lunch.
Yes.
Well, the wind is picking up, isn't it, Paul?
It is, certainly is, Mr. Dyer.
Yes. Just enjoying the...
lovely weather for ducks.
Well, yes, quite.
After you, sir.
Exactly.
Yeah. The theatre mob. So, yeah. It's pre-performance. Any nerves? Nervous?
With all modesty, no more than usual. Because we've done this a few times.
Yeah. Look at the rain.
Yes.
Okay, so let's chops away. Tally ho.
Tally ho.
Hello. You're ready to go.
Hello. We are here in the aftermath of the first show. And it has been a really, really good show, which will be available on DVD, I believe, at some point. And we've had our half, me doing Roald Dahl poems, the others doing tributes to Richard Stilgoe, and he'll be in the performance this evening, so maybe we will catch him on camera after the performance.
Maybe
also we'll be hearing from my colleague Angus, who will give us a chat on camera.
Yeah.
But this is all for the purposes of giving you some of the aftermath atmosphere.
This is marvellous. Went very well, didn't it?
Indeed.
Yeah. And you expanded and improvised very well.
Oh, thank you.
You milked it so well that we have to bring the churns in.
Well,
for the milk.
You had the audience to react to during the shows. That's the point.
I thought they were a bit subdued. I mean, as far, they would clap, but you know, I wanted to cheer.
Well,
so
we'll
good.
See. We'll see how it goes tonight.
This
hopefully,
evening, yeah.
We're getting
well, in the end, it did cheer, but you know, the performances were so good. We're going.
Well, here we are with Angus and Luke, spontaneously on the tape. First reflections on tonight's performance, Angus.
Oh,
is Angus?
Hello. This is wonderful ideas of what Anne and Jenny and this thing story so far of us telling of the 20 years of Orpheus.
It's brilliant.
And
yeah.
It's all come together, and it's a dream.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. It's got, you keep going and keep going strong.
Yes.
The singing.
Yes.
Just, it's amazing.
I need to keep my level and keep working and keep improving, because you never stop learning.
Exactly. And Luke's brilliant singing as well. Excellent singing. Yeah, how far have you come today, Luke?
Sorry.
Okay. Not too far then.
I think it's really fantastic to be given the opportunity to do this with old friends and be back together.
Yeah, it's brilliant. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, it was great fantastic. Singing. Anyway, but you know, all the singing is amazing.
Yeah,
it really
you.
Is.
And what might amuse you to is that Paul didn't even know that we were doing the second show.
Ah, that's right.
Oh.
Rory told me, but my brain isn't quite as young as it used to be. Yeah. So how far have you come?
I've come from the outskirts of Tunbridge Paddock Wood.
Right.
Yes.
Nice area.
Family lived up in Swanwick. Yeah. Yes. It's a not bad area.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. We'll just make a little film. Rory's idea.
Yes.
just you know, around the performance.
Hello.
It'll be on my Facebook.
Oh, Jamie, by the way, what happened to the DVD of the
I
put my name down.
Okay. I know.
Oh, good artwork.
So you're in charge of it.
Yeah, no pressure.
Rory, do you want fish and chips later?
Oh, yes, please.
Do you want fish and chips later?
No fish, just chips, please.
And I'm just going to write my name in case I miss anything. Sorry, I forgot your name again.
Paul.
And I'm Rory.
I know who you are. And Angus, you want fish and chips?
Yes, please.
Luke, fish and chips?
Yes, please.
Yes. Yes. Will it have our names on the Orpheus, the mythical? Well, we don't know.
Oh, good. I hope so. Yeah, of course it should do.
It's in the film. It comes up in the film, I think.
Yeah.
We're waiting on the artwork.
Oh, okay.
Well, that was spontaneous.
Yeah, that was wonderful.
Professional. And we'll have some more later on, I guess.
Oh, hopefully. Okay.
Sir Richard Stilgoe. Would you agree with me that, having said that, it would be criminal not to ask him to come and perform for us? Richard, would you do that?
Gosh, thank you, Anne. I get far too much credit for this, I really do. It was really interesting, it's been really interesting. And the real people who have made it work are these guys. Particularly, if I may single out you two, who were two of the very first Brave Five, who arrived on day one to start the Orpheus Centre, and we immediately sent you home, didn't we? Because we weren't ready. And then we sort of got a bit ready, and you two, and Lorna, and Jamie, and Danny Thomas, yeah, got it all started. And it has been taken on by so many young people, by people like Anne, now under the chairmanship of John. It's safe and secure, and I hardly have to bother about it at all, and it's a joy. And I could go on forever about the last 20 years.
Tops bend.
We're still going strong.
It's been 20 years,
and we're still going strong.
Song Sea Shanty.
Well, there you go.
The famous. What you do
with a drunken sailor? What do we do with a drunken sailor? What do we do with a drunken sailor? Early in the morning. Hey oh, up she rises. Hey oh, up she rises. Hey oh, up she rises. Early in the morning. Stick him in the bed with the captain's daughter. Stick him in the bed with the captain's daughter. Stick him in the bed with the captain's daughter. Early in the morning. Hey, oh, up she rises, her eye in the morning. Shave his belly with a rusty razor, shave his belly with a rusty razor, shave his belly with a rusty razor, her eye in the morning. Hey, oh, and up she rises, hey, oh, and up she rises, hey, oh, and up she rises, her eye in the morning. Stick him in the longboat till he's sober, stick him in the longboat till he's sober, stick him in the longboat till he's sober, in the morning. Hey, oh, up she rises. Hey, oh, up she rises. Hey, oh, up she rises. In the morning.
Which it is, because it's like 12:15. Past midnight.
And that was a little extra that wasn't even in the show on the stage.
See what you're getting?
But it was a show on our stage. Thank you very much.
Stop moaning.
Thank you very much for joining
us. Got your
us.
Money's